Do you want to use Excel more efficiently? Do you want to be able to go home earlier? If you answered yes to either of these questions, then you need to watch this video. The VLOOKUP is the most useful, yet most misunderstood function in Excel. This is a step-by-step VLOOKUP tutorial which works in all versions of Excel. It will save you hours with analysis. VLOOKUPs are usually done between different spreadsheets, but to make it easier to show how they work, I put the data onto one spreadsheet. The tables in the spreadsheet have some of the most famous runners in the world, including Usain Bolt, the world champion. The runners are numbered from 1 to 10 in column B. The numbers are for illustrative purposes only. The names of the runners are in column C. It is important to note that the tables on the left-hand side are set in ascending numerical order from 1 to 10. However, the table on the right-hand side is arranged in alphabetical order, using the names of the athletes. So, the numbers in that table are not in ascending order. We use the VLOOKUP function to get the prize money each athlete has won in column J in the second table into column D in the first table. Step 1. First, click into cell D2, as this is where we want the first VLOOKUP result to appear. Step 2. Click on the FX button above column B. Many people start by typing equals VLOOKUP, but you don't have to. Clicking the FX button is much quicker. When you click the FX button, you will see the Insert Function table pop up. From this window, we will select the VLOOKUP function, as it is one of the most recently used functions in the category. If the VLOOKUP function is not listed as one of the most recently used functions, then change the or select a category field to all, then scroll to the bottom, where you will see the word VLOOKUP. Once you find the VLOOKUP option, you can simply click on it. Click OK, and the function arguments window will pop up. This table will show the syntax, which is a fancy word for the format of the formula, and it will display the different parts of the syntax. In this case, the syntax is VLOOKUP, parentheses, lookup value, table array, call index, num range, lookup. Step 3. Here, you should click into cell B2, because that's the first number or reference for which you want to look up a value. The lookup value is for the corresponding value we want to find in the first column of the second table. So, we want to find out what prize money the runner in position 1 got in the table that spans columns H to J. Step 4. Now click in the next field, the table array field. A table array consists of two or more columns of data in the first column in the table array. In this case, column H has the corresponding numbers that the lookup value is looking at. In other words, the runner positions in this example. Step 5. After clicking in the table array field, you then need to highlight the columns that you want to look up the data from. Here, we will highlight columns H to J, because our lookup value column starts from column H in the second table, and the prize money which we want to check is in column J. An alternative way to populate the table array field is to highlight the range of data you're looking up, starting with your first unique value, in this case, cell H2. So, you'd highlight cells H2 to J11, because J11 is the last cell in the range. You then need to fix this table array by putting dollar signs in before the H, before the 2, before the J, and before the 11. If you're in the table array field and you press F4 on your keyboard, Excel will do this automatically for you. This is useful to know if the spreadsheet doesn't allow you to highlight cells H to J because some cells are merged or you're getting an invalid error. But for now, just leave it, ensure your fields look the same as those in the screenshot above, and then proceed to step 6. Step 6. When you highlight the columns, you should note that column J is the third column from column H. We then move on to the next step, call index num, which is the column index number. Click on that field and type the number 3. This is because column J is 3 columns away from column H. Step 7. Now, for the last step, simply click in the range lookup field and type in the word false. You should always type in the word false here, because we want the VLOOKUP to return an exact match for what we're looking for, and if it doesn't, we want it to return the word false. Now click OK, and like magic, you will notice that the VLOOKUP has returned a figure of $1 million beside Usain Bolt's name in the first table. If you look at the second table, the figure of $1 million is also against Usain Bolt's name, so we know the VLOOKUP has worked. And that's how you string together the VLOOKUP formula in Excel. Now all you have to do is drag down the formula so that the cells below cell D2 populate, and you save yourself the hassle of manually finding the corresponding prize money value for each and every athlete in the first table. In a work scenario, if you had hundreds of rows of data, this would literally save you hours of work. Congratulations on finishing the tutorial. That's all for now. Please subscribe or put comments in the video below to let us know what you thought.